Hi, this is Mike from Memeception Academy, and in this tutorial, we will encrypt data using the program 7-Zip. It's a very easy exercise, and for those who have never encrypted their data before, this is an easy way to get started. If you have been working with your PC for a long time, you have certainly got to know the file format zip. With this format, files can be compressed. If you have a lot of files and they are very large, all these files can be combined into a zip container. The program tries to reduce the size of the files. Here in the video, you can see such a file, and in Windows, a file with the extension zip is shown with the zipper. But I tell you about the zip program because you can also encrypt your data symmetrically in a very simple way. And I want to show you now how this works. Here in the Windows Explorer, you can see two files, a picture and a text file. Let's assume that the text file contains a secret message. And these two files I want to encrypt with the program 7-Zip. This program is free and can be installed before. I select both files, and with the right mouse button, I open the context menu. Here is the entry 7-Zip, and I select here the entry Add to Archive. The dialog of the program 7-Zip opens, and here I can now perform some settings. Here above, you can see the file name under which the zip file will be saved. This is only a suggestion, and you can change the name depending on your needs. I will enter another file name here. Here below, you see the area encryption, and there you can enter a password. From your password, a symmetric key will be created. And depending on which algorithm is set here below, this key will be used to encrypt your data symmetrically. I will enter a password. And set the algorithm to AES 256. I press OK and the zip file is created. OK, as you can see, a new zip file has been created here and it contains both files encrypted. If I want to unzip the files again, then I select the zip file and press the right mouse button. Again, I select 7-Zip. And then choose the entry Extracts to Secrets. The dialog of the tool opens again, and this time I am asked for the password. I enter a fake password so you can see what happens. You see, it shows me that the password was wrong. Let's have a look at the result in the Explorer. You see, it has created the files, but the content is empty. This is logical because it could not decrypt the content of the files. The password was wrong. Okay, I delete the empty files and start the program 7-Zip again. This time I enter the correct password. You see the files were created again. I open the text file again. And this time the text is included. So the decryption was successful. That was very simple. The next thing I want to show you in this video is the content of the zip files. I have opened my hex editor here, and with it I can look at every single byte of any file. I open with this program our unencrypted zip file, and we can see here now what exactly is contained in this file. Here on the left, the positions of the bytes are shown in hexadecimal form. In the middle is the actual content, again in hexadecimal form. Next to it on the right is the ASCII code. We can see that the file name is stored here somewhere. And we can also read the content of the text file, which we packed into the zip file. We see here the text, "This is a test." For comparison, I have opened the encrypted zip file in the hex editor as well. And also here we can read the file name. But what we don't see here is the content of the text file. And that's how it should be, because we encrypted the content symmetrically. A symmetric key was derived from our password, and this was used to encrypt the data with the algorithm AES. So with the hex editor, we can check if the encryption really has worked. As we have already seen in the hex editor, the file names are not encrypted in the zip format. The last thing I want to show you is how you can encrypt them as well. Currently, the zip format doesn't provide this, but 7-zip has its own archive format, and so the file names can be encrypted as well. I mark both files and open the dialog again. Here in the list box, you simply select the format 7Z in the archive format. So this time, we don't use the format zip, but 7Z. It appears here under the algorithm additionally this checkbox, and if you activate this, then all file names are also encrypted. Okay, that's the end of this exercise. I have shown you how you can quickly encrypt your files with a zip program. I have used the tool 7zip. But you can also use other zip tools like WinZip. Just enter the terms 7-zip or WinZip in Google and you will get results where you can learn about these tools.